So after the topic product of electrolysis, the last topic of the electrochemistry is batteries. Batteries is the combination of cells. You may say cell is singular and batteries is plural. So there are two type of cell, primary cell and secondary cell. Or batteries. Primary cells are those cells which are used once in its lifetime. After its use, it has no capacity to recharge. So it has no number of charging and discharging cycle. So in primary cell, in our syllabus, the first is Leclanché cell, or only called primary batteries. In this primary cell or battery, these cells are not chargeable because electrode reactions occur only once. And after the use, over a period of time, the cells become dead and cannot be reused. The most familiar example of the type of cell is Leclanché cell. After its discoverer, it consists of zinc container that also act as an anode. And the cathode is a carbon, you may say graphite rod, surrounded by powdered manganese dioxide, MnO2, and carbon. The space between the electrode is filled by moist paste of ammonium chloride and zinc chloride. The electrode reactions are at anode. Zn solid gives Zn2 plus plus 2 electron at cathode, MnO2 plus NH4 plus plus 1 electron gives MnOOH plus NH3. The cell has a potential near 1.5 volt. The major disadvantage of this cell is that its cell potential gradually decreases. Due to this reason, the electrical gadget may corroded by the another type of chemical reaction in which ammonia produced in the reaction forms a complex with Zn2 plus to give Zn NH3 whole 4 square bracket 2 plus. So we use another type of primary cell which are more sensible and more useful than Leclanché cell. The second primary cell is mercury cell, or it is also known as button cell. It is used in camera, watches, and another sophisticated electrical gadget because its cell potential is constant, never change. So it saves the electrical gadget. In this say primary cell, zinc mercury amalgam act as an anode, and paste of HGO and carbon act as a cathode. The electrolyte is a paste of KOH and zinc oxide. The cell reaction is at anode ZnHg plus 2OH minus gives zinc oxide plus H2O plus 2 electrons. At cathode HgO plus H2O plus 2 electrons gives Hg liquid plus 2OH minus. The overall cell reaction is zinc Hg plus H2O, HgO gives zinc oxide plus Hg. The cell potential is 1.35 volt approximately, and it is remains constant, so it is more useful than Leclanché cell. After this, we study the secondary batteries or cell. Secondary battery is rechargeable and can be used again and again. It is recharged by passing current through it from an external source. Most familiar example of secondary cell is lead storage battery, commonly used in automobiles and inverters. It consists of a lead anode and a grid of lead packed with lead dioxide PbO2 as a cathode. A 38% solution of H2SO4 is used as a electrolyte. The cell reactions when the battery is in use. When we use battery, you can say battery is in discharge condition. Okay, so the cell reaction at anode Pb solid plus SO42 minus aqua gives PbSO4 plus 2 electrons. At cathode, PbO2 plus SO42 minus aqua plus 4H plus plus 2 electrode gives PbSO4 plus 2H2O. The overall reaction may be Pb solid plus PbO2 plus 2H2SO4 aqua gives PbSO4 plus 2H2O. After that, the cell reaction during recharging, the cell operate like an electrolytic cell. The reaction is reversed and lead sulfate PbSO4 on anode and cathode is converted into Pb and PbO2. So at anode, PbSO4 plus 2H2O gives PbO2 plus SO42 minus plus 4H plus plus 2 electrode. At cathode, PbSO4 plus 2 electrode gives Pb plus SO42 minus. Another example of secondary battery is nickel cadmium cell, which is more expensive than lead storage battery, but which has longer life than the lead storage cell, but due to costly, it is less used in day-to-day life. The overall reaction during discharge of the battery is cadmium solid plus 2NiOH3 gives CdO plus 2NiOH2 plus H2O. The another type of battery is fuel cell. Fuel cell are those cells which produce electrical energy directly from the combustion of fuels such as hydrogen, carbon monoxide or methane, The most successful fuel cell is hydrogen oxygen H2-O2 cell. Utilize the reactions between hydrogen and oxygen to produce water. Hydrogen and oxygen are bubbled through a porous carbon electrode in the cell into concentrated aqueous sodium hydroxide. Catalysts are incorporated into the electrode. The electrode reaction is at anode 2H2 plus 4OH minus gives 4H2O plus 4 electrode. Cathode reaction is O2 plus 2H2O plus 4 electrode gives 4OH minus. Overall reaction is H2 plus O2 2H2. Advantage of fuel cells. It is a pollution free device since no harmful products are formed. Its efficiency is about 70%. So, which is considerably higher than convenient or conventional secondary cells. These cells are light in weight as compared to the electrical generator to produce corresponding quantity of power. It is a continuous source of energy if the supply of gases is maintained. So, the next topic is corrosion. Corrosion is the eating away of metal in the presence of air and moisture is said to be corrosion. In day-to-day life, we face various or several phase of corrosion. Corrosion in iron is called rusting. Another example of corrosion is corroded of silver due to deposition of Ag2X in copper utensils. It produces green-blue coating due to basic copper carbonate. So, chemically, rust is hydrated ferric oxide Fe2O3.xH2O. Corrosion is considered as electrochemical phenomenon. According to electrochemical theory of rusting, the impure iron surface behaves like a small electrochemical cell in the presence of moisture containing oxygen or CO2. Such a cell is called corrosion cell or corrosion couple. In this miniature corrosion cells, the pure iron act as an anode and impure surface area act as a cathode. And moisture having dissolved carbon dioxide or oxygen act as an electrolyte. At anode, oxidation reaction takes place. Fe atom converted into Fe2+, leaving behind electrode. Fe gives Fe2+ plus 2 electrode. Standard electrode potential is equal to minus 0.44 volt at cathode. Electrons are picked up by the hydrogen ion H+, which are produced from decomposition of H2CO3, which is obtained by the reaction of H2O plus CO2 H2CO3. The decomposition reaction is as H2CO3 reversible sign 2H+ plus carbonate ion. H+ ion form reduce the dissolved oxygen 2H plus plus half O2 plus plus 2 electrode gives H2O. Electrode potential is 1.23 volt. The overall reaction is Fe plus 2H plus plus half O2 gives Fe2 plus plus H2O. Enote cell is 1.67 volt. The ferrous ion so formed move through water and come at the surface, where these are further oxidized by atmospheric oxygen to ferric ion and form rust, which is hydrated ferric oxide 2Fe2 plus plus half O2 plus 2H2O gives Fe2O3 plus 4H plus Fe2O3 plus XH2O Fe2O3 dot XH2O. So all the reaction is about rusting of iron. You may see the mechanism of rusting of iron. Rusting of iron is increased when any electrolyte dissolve in water. The next topic or last topic is prevention of corrosion. The metal surface can be protected against corrosion by the following methods. Number one, barrier protection. A thin film is introduced between iron and atmospheric oxygen, carbon dioxide and moisture. The following methods are adopted for the deposition thin film on metal surface. By covering the surface with paint or a thin film of grease. And second is electroplating iron with some non-corrosive metals such as nickel, chromium, copper, etc., which are less reactive than copper. The second most important is sacrificial protection. In this method, iron surface is covered with more electropositive metal than iron, which gets oxidized in preference to iron. In such a situation, more electropositive metal loses electrons instead of iron, and thus this metal is sacrificed at the cost of iron, hence the name sacrificial protection. Iron is generally coated with zinc, and this process is called galvanization. The next method is electrical protection. This is also a case of sacrificial protection. This method is used for the protection of underground water pipes or iron taps. In this method, the exposed surface of iron is protected by connecting it to a block of some active metal such as magnesium, aluminium or zinc. This more electropositive metal such act as a node and the loose electron in preference to iron. The iron surface acts as a cathode. This method therefore is called cathodic protection. The electrons released at the anode are accepted by H plus ion of water at that surface of iron. More electropositive metal is consumed gradually in the process and need periodical replacement. So, in this manner, the iron is protected by air and moisture. So, by studying this topic, electrochemistry chapter is finished.